Oh, okay.
Oh,
Just
nice.
down the road.
Oh, are you guys close by?
We're in Gallatin.
Okay, well, we are just down the road. I hope you don't mind. My cat has joined me. He has begged to get in through the door.
My dog is out here somewhere.
Yeah, Bentley's out here somewhere.
Well, I've been wanting to talk to you guys. I see you, Robin, at a distance, you know, just when I'm talking with John, and you will be always nearby. So it's good to be face to face with both of you.
Yes, it is. I try to keep my distance.
You should never do that. How are y'all
I'm
handling?
I'm usually the one out front talking. So.
This Faith Family and Friends has given us a whole new platform for us to do together, as opposed to here I am and Robin's part of the band or just in a support role. It's much cooler.
But you know,
he's got me talking so much he wishes I'd just be quiet now. So.
I can't believe that, because I know for sure you're a wonderful singer. Well, talk to me a little bit about how you guys are handling the pandemic.
It did come to a screeching halt as far as, you know, our touring. So we had to get creative and come up with something else to do, you know.
And we had a dear friend who is in Chicago radio and just has a podcast, and John has been a guest on his show several times, and he loves to come down and visit, and he and John have been working on a book, and he said, you know, you two guys ought to do a podcast together. And we're like, oh, no. And so because of the quarantine, we decided, you know, maybe this is a chance. So John got two microphones out, and we just started talking, and it developed into what we call Faith, Family, and Friends. And we decided to reach out to other people that are musicians, politicians, coaches, athletes, I mean, all kinds of people from all genres of life, and talk to them about their faith and their family and their friends and how it's impacted their career and what they do.
You know, I've noticed too that on this, you have, the people you've reached out to, you know, like you said, a lot of them are very well known. And one that really stood out to me was that, I guess you did the last interview that Charlie Daniels did, and he joined you for your show. That hasn't aired yet, has it?
No, matter of fact, we just finished editing it today. There's just been lots of times where we just have to hit the pause button and just literally wipe away some tears. I mean, it's really, really quite special.
You know, Charlie was always one that he didn't hold back in talking about anything, especially family and his faith. And I'm sure that's the conversation you got into with him.
Oh,
it's unbelievable. 65 minutes of conversation with him that we pretty well just left it untouched, because it is just something that we will cherish for our entire lifetime. He covers his faith extensively. With a tear in his eye, he lays out the plan of salvation. It's just really a beautiful, beautiful conversation.
He talks about his love for country and love for our military, and most of all, his love for Miss Hazel.
Yeah.
And it's just a wonderful, wonderful conversation. It'll air this coming Friday. A week from Friday.
I look forward to hearing that. Yeah. Thought a lot of Charlie. He was a dear friend for a very long time. I met him first when I was working in rock and roll, and then met him through country, you know, and I mean, kept running into him through country. And when I was working out at the Opry, of course, he was out there a lot too, but just that whole family, just a very special family. Some of the other guests that you have coming up, and I know you have surprise guests. I don't know if you're going to drop any of those today, but if you could run over some of the guests that are going to be on your podcast, that would be awesome.
Well, with football season fired up, we had the great honor of getting to visit with Coach Vince Dooley and his wife, Barbara, from the University of Georgia.
You know, we're from Athens, and I grew up in Athens and went to school at the University of Georgia. So he's just an icon in college football and in the Southeastern Conference, and it was just so much fun talking to the two of them. We have also got national correspondent from Inside Edition, Miss Megan Alexander, who just joined Bill Cody on Coffee Country and Cody and WSM.
And down the line, we got Bill Cody joining us also.
Yeah. It's been so much fun. We have T. Graham Brown and his wife, Sheila, who is also his business partner. And she was funny. She's like, this is the very first time I've ever been interviewed. And so for us as a couple to interview another couple, it's a unique experience to talk to them because they live like we do.
Yeah. Scott Hamilton, the Olympic skater.
Yeah.
Got to visit with Scott and go through so much of his life I was not familiar with. He's faced a lot of trials in his life, and he is just a wonderful man. Loved talking with him.
I have a question for you from an interviewer's point. You know, and of course, I've been doing this for a lot of years. The gray hairs will show it. Does it feel different being on that side of it? And sometimes do you hold back asking questions that you'd like to know? Or is it just a matter of getting in conversation with people that you feel comfortable with?
I think that it's for us, it's just conversation because we don't know any better. You know, we just try to talk to them because we don't really, we're not schooled in how to interview people by any stretch.
And certainly John said, because I would lay awake at night, I was so nervous having a voice, and I just was very nervous about speaking with people. But he said, you know, we just need to ask the questions because these people know how to talk. And after listening to John do so many interviews, I mean, that's the truth. He can sit there and talk and just tell you his story, and they know how to talk to you and tell their story. So we don't do a lot of talking, but we try to ask great questions that make them think and make them pull from their heart maybe a story that they've never told before.
And we're after those stories about how their faith, their family, and their friends have impacted their careers, but mostly how it's impacted their lives.
Wow. You know, you have always, John, spoken from the heart. And I've always known that in interviews with you. And just knowing Robin vaguely through John, I realized the same thing. And the two of you together, I can imagine becoming great conversationalist with people. And I think of that, like T. Graham Brown, for instance, you guys all went through something basically together, probably had a lot of the same experiences with the music industry, a husband and wife team. That's not always the case. And I would imagine that expands into not just the spiritual, but some of the things you experienced career-wise that maybe challenged your spiritual side at times. Is that true?
Yes. We actually took on some other couples, and it was quite fascinating. I really enjoyed talking to Dwayne Allen and his wife, Nora Lee, from the Oak Ridge Boys, and of course, her with her incredible career on the Grand Ole Opry. I mean, that was fascinating to talk to them. And another couple that works in the business together that we talked to was Jimmy Fortune and his wife, Nina, who work together. And so there's a lot of couples that are in the business together that do what we do, and they make it work. And so I've been fascinated hearing their stories of what they do behind the scenes and how they make it work as a couple.
Are they coming? When you're recording this, are you going to their house, or are you sitting at your house? How are you doing it? I'm just curious.
We're doing it on the phone right now.
Are you?
Yeah, we have a recording studio here at home, and we've patched minutes out. The sound quality is remarkably good considering. And so it's been a lot of fun to be able to do that. Hopefully before too long, we'll be able to do some in-person visits like that and maybe put a video component to it. That would be fun.
Yeah, with the quarantine starting, we did not
it'll be over my house in a minute.
Have the chance to go to people's houses. Originally, that's what our plan was, but when we all got stuck inside, you know, this was the way we ended up having to do it, and it has been good. It has been good. Yeah.
It is. This is how we do things during COVID.
Yes.
We do have a setup with, you know, once the quarantine's over and we can get out and visit with people, we have a portable rig that we'll take with us and then come back home to the studio to put it all together. So.
Well, you've done a lot of television even in the last few years. So you've got the crews and the people that know how to put those things together and help you out with that too.
Yeah, there's crews of people to help us. What time do they get here?
Funny for us, because we've had to learn a whole bunch of new technology with us being stuck at home.
Yeah.
And people can't come over. So we've had to learn more than we...
I've learned more about Pro Tools recording than I ever wanted to know. She's learned more about editing.
I told him he was spoiled because he's had for years people to do it for him. And now with this, he's had to learn how to do it.
Oh, I see. You are your crew.
Yes.
You are your crew. I'm my crew too. So, hey, here we are. Two crews together.
Yeah. I'm the president janitor. She does everything else. Wait a minute. Maybe I'm just the janitor.
Well, speaking of technology, you know, what I have learned is the question is not like if I'm trying to find a piece of equipment for something, it's not whether or not that equipment exists. It's whether or not I can get my hands on it, because pretty much anything you can think you can do technology anymore.
Yes.
Which I love.
A lot of great stuff out there.
I'm looking forward to the podcast. Let's tell everyone how to find you so that they can.
Well, the best way is to go to johnberry.com. And there on our homepage is a picture of the two of us. And it says Faith, Family, and Friends. And there's a tab across the bottom to
subscribe here. And you're just going to click on that. And that's going to take you to our Patreon page that is going to give you all kinds of information and videos. And it's kind of interesting. The way we're doing our podcast, it's kind of a John Berry community that we are building upon. There's a level that they can choose from that's just the podcast, and they get an email from us.
A monthly email.
And then there's a level called The Faithful that's got a whole lot of things that people can benefit from, like free VIP access to pre-show events and t-shirts and early music and all kinds of stuff. So
John Berry store coupon.
Yeah.
For all those coupon shoppers.
There's kind of two different ways to look at it. Just the podcast or being part of the John Berry community through the Faithful platform.
It's almost like a modern, the Faithful is sort of like a modern day fan club.
That's what I like.
Yeah.
That sounds wonderful. You know, and I cannot hang up this Zoom call without saying something about your wonderful music. And I know it hasn't been that long since you recorded a great album that touched a lot of people. And you've recorded so many great songs through the years. And being in radio first, I've played every single one of them. You know, I thought I'd throw up a picture of one of our interviews.
Oh, wow. That's
awesome.
And I'm not sure who your two bodyguards are there, but
Terry.
Terry Oliver. Well, let me get a close up here. Let me get a close up.
They look like your bodyguards that day. I know, I'm just joking.
Yeah, there's Terry Oliver back there. What a great guy.
Yeah.
He lives down in South Georgia, and I can't see who the other one is. That's awesome.
They were super nice that day. I want to say, Robin, you were there that day. That was at 103 KDF in Nashville. Morning.
I probably was. A lot of times I like to get off and go inside and be an observer.
Well, it's good to see you both. You have a lovely yard.
Not anymore.
You have a lovely yard.
Thank you. We like to garden, actually. We both take care of the yard ourselves, and we have just some amazing plants, and we really do enjoy being outside in our yard and taking care of it.
We love it.
Same here. I've been planting flowers for the last few years here, and finally they're showing their faces, you know, every year.
Yeah.
Well, have a wonderful day, Robin.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Good to see you.
You too.
Okay.